Hello everybody, so let us continue with the continuation topic of the second module concept, that is shell interpretive concept. So in the previous session we had discussed with a few of the concept. Those concepts are, that is, one is with the wildcards, in which by using those wildcards, which actually consists of a meta characters, so those special meta characters are used for what? Providing those meta characters to an argument, so you can list out more number of files which are being provided to a command. Okay, so that we have discussed. So in that we have discussed with so many meta characters like star, question mark, dot, character class, within that negation of character class, so all those things. Along with that, even we had discussed with escaping and quoting concept. So in which those two concepts are basically used for what? Ignoring the meaning of the special characters. Okay, so if the user want to ignore the meaning of a special character, so at that time we are going to use this escaping and quoting. Followed by, next we discussed with the redirection concept. So in that redirection concept, we had discussed with what? Three of the standard files. So those three standard files are, one is the standard input file, standard output file, and standard error file. So what actually the standard input file? So standard input file is basically used for what? Since if I consider a terminal, that is a shell terminal, so what happens, until and unless the user is going to key in something, it will be idle. So all the data what you are going to provide as an input or get the output or any kind of an error message, all those stream of data are what? Displayed on the terminal. So these data can be categorized like providing an input, getting an output, as well as the error message can be displayed on the terminal stream by using these three standard files. So in that, one of the standard file is what? Standard input file, followed by next is standard output file, next is standard error file. So this is going to use what? A terminal. So within that terminal, a keyboard itself is a default stream for providing a stream of input. Likewise, next is what? Along with the keyboard, even we do have a redirection symbol which is used for this. So that is less than symbol. So this is the redirection symbol which is used for providing an input to the any of the command by using the standard file. Input file. Next is what? Standard output file. So this also again, this belongs to an display content, because standard output file, in the name itself, it says that you are trying to display the content, right? So that has been, again here the default is what? The screen or the terminal itself for displaying the output. And even by using one of the redirection operator has been used, that is greater than symbol, and one more is greater than symbol. So this is used for what? Displaying the output. So you can redirect from one file to another file for displaying the output. So for that you can use this symbol. Likewise, by using this redirection operator in the input file, you can read the input from another file to one of the command. Next is what? Standard error file. So here this has also been error itself. It says that you are displaying the message, error message of that particular file or the which has been provided as an argument to a command. So here also this is going to be displayed on the screen. But while displaying these error messages, so all these three standard files, what it is going to take is, it is going to consider its file descriptor number. So the three file descriptor numbers have been used for this standard input file, output file, and followed by what? Error file. So 0 for standard input file, 1 for standard output file, and 2 for what? Standard error file. So by using this prefix, by prefixing these to a redirection symbol, you are going to what? So from which file you are displaying the error message, whether it was through the input file, while reading the input you got the error, or while displaying the output you got the error, like this. So this has been, these three descriptor numbers are used for displaying the error message. So these are the contents what we have discussed in the previous session. So the next concept within this is what? Connecting commands. So what is this connecting commands? So in the name itself it says that. So in the initial session also about this Unix programming, we had discussed that Unix has a flexibility of combining two commands, right? And also it has what? You can provide within the same terminal screen, a data of input can be provided by providing by using its secondary prompt. So this has also been provided, right? So this flexibility is there in the Unix. So here also in the shell, like while if you can what? connect two commands, but how you are going to connect two commands? Let me consider one of the example here and make you understand that how this connecting commands work using this pipe concept or pipeline concept. Okay, so how it has been considered. So here, even consider this one FD example what I have written. So who, what does this who command do? So who, I have used redirection operator followed by user.text. So what does this command line says here? So who, redirection operator. So this redirection operator is of what? Standard output. And you are redirecting the output of who command to what? User.text file. So this flexibility is there in the Unix. You can connect two commands, right? So here I'm not connecting two commands. Instead, I'm redirecting the output of who command to what? User.text. Next is below line. I'm trying to display whether that content has been copied to that user.text. If it is copied, I am trying to view it. So cat command is used for what? Viewing, right? Viewing the content, viewing the content. So cat command is used for viewing the content. So who, redirection operator, then you are redirecting the who command output to user.text. Cat command is trying to what? Display the content of user.text, whether it has been copied or not. You are viewing it. If it is copied, obviously it can be viewed. Next is what? I'm actually trying to what? Get that input from the user.txt file and get the count of what? Number of lines within that who command. So how it can be done? So if I want to count the number of lines, so one of number of lines or characters or word, so one of the command used in the Unix is what? WC command. So this WC command I'm going to use with an option L for what? Getting the input from the input data from user.txt to WC-L. So in this command, what happens? So what actually, why I'm trying to explain this is, so in the first command line, we actually redirected the output to what? User.txt. The who command output has been redirected to user.txt with an output, standard output file. Next, I'm trying to view it. So this is just for our reference for whether the content has been copied or not. To view it, I'm trying to take this command. Okay. So, but in the next line, what I have done here is, you are trying to get the input of user.txt input. From this file, you are trying to get the input of this user.txt to what? WC-L. So this is the redirection symbol which is used for fetching the input from what? The user.txt file to WC-L. So WC command is basically used for counting the number of lines, characters and words. So if you have provided an option -L, which means that you are trying to display the number of lines. So what has happened here, I have considered one intermediary file, right? So one intermediary file I have considered, which is acting as a temporary file for both the command, who command and WC command. So for this, both who and WC command, this is acting as what? And temporary file. And from the same file, we are fetching the, providing the input output data to user.txt. And from the same file, I'm fetching the input to what? WC command. So here I'm trying to connect these two commands. But here how I have connected here? So I have connected through this redirection symbols, right? So just to what? Here it is taking intermediary file, and the disk space which has been allocated for this file is, in no time it might take what? More disk space. Because whenever you are trying to execute a long running command, so as of now it is just a simple command. What if in case if I am trying to execute a long running command which includes more number of commands again? So as of now I am just connecting with the two commands. What if in case if I am trying to what? Connect more than one command, that is more than two or three commands. So at that time it might take what? A long running command might take much time also for execution of that, and in no time it might take disk space more also. So just to overcome these advantages, so we have, the shell has what? One of the concept, that is connecting the two command concept. The shell is going to set that how it is going to connect the two commands by using a concept called pipe. So that is what this pipes refers to. So pipe, what it does is, it is going to connect the two commands. It is not going to use this intermediary file like that for copying the content output to user.txt, again getting the input from user.txt to what? WC command. So these are the two commands I'm trying to execute or connect it, right? I'm trying to connect these two commands. But how do I connect directly instead of using this intermediary file? So that is what I have written here. So disadvantage of using this kind of connecting two commands, the disadvantage is long running commands might take the process will be slowed. And second command what have given, so it is going to what, wait until the first command has completed its job and it can't even act at all. Okay, so that is what the one of the disadvantage of using this who command. Followed by next is what, user need an intermediary file. So as I have written here, user.txt is an intermediary file that has to be removed after completion of the job. Yes, of course. So after this completion of the job, that user.txt will have to be removed. So which is going to build up a space, a disk space more by using that intermediary or temporary file. So that is the disadvantage of using this kind of connecting two commands with redirection symbol. So just to avoid this kind of disk space and making the process to execute slow and all, the shell is going to provide us with one of the good feature of how to connect two commanders, that is the concept of pipe. So pipe, what it does is it is going to directly connect two commands, fetching, getting the output of it and fetching that as an input to another command. So that is what I have written here, as you can see here. So I am directly connected. So here we are not going to use any, we have not used any intermediary file like user.txt file. Instead, a pipeline itself is acting as what? Intermediary feature for connecting these two commands. So who is going to get connected with what? WC by using a pipe. So this output of who command is provided as an input to what? To the WC-L command. So this is how you can execute what? Connecting the two commands using pipe. So this is the disadvantage of it, and next this is what the advantage, or sorry, this is how you are going to access this who pipe WC-L. So next is what, next even you can connect, one more example I can take. So if I consider ls, so ls what it is going to does, so it is going to list out all my files under that current directory. So that can be piped, and I can make that to again display with what, I can get connect with that with WC-L command. So this is about your connecting command by using a pipe concept. Okay, so the two disadvantages, so usually when we are going to try to connect two commands means an intermediary file will get has to be used. So just to avoid this kind of intermediary file and taking more process time more, as well as disk spaces will also be occupied. So just to avoid all these disadvantages, we go with this pipe command. The next concept within this is what? That is basic and extended regular expression. So what actually we are going to understand in this particular concept? So in the previous concept, we had understood that is shell interpretive cycle. Okay, so how the command is going to be interpreted within this shell and how it is going to get executed. So usually what happens, once the command line has been provided as an input to the shell prompt, so shell what it does is it is going to first expand that, scan that input command line and expand any meta characters or any special symbols have been provided, and it is going to abbreviate it. So after expanding, identifying and expanding that, then only it is going to process that special symbol and get the out, process that, and finally it is going to pass to the kernel for the execution, and until kernel is going to get the output of it, so shell is going to wait for that, and once it has got the prompt saying that out execution has been completed, shell is going to once again prompt the command for the next input command line. So this is how it is going to work. And also we have understood the redirection redirection symbols like standard input file, output file and error file, followed by connecting pipes. So that is what I had just discussed now. So the next concept within this chapter is basic and extended regular expression. So what actually this basic and extended regular expression does here? So this regular expression, what actually this is, so by using one, by using these expression, user is going to try to search for a pattern from a file. Okay, so what if in case if the user want to search any pattern within a file, might be that pattern where actually it is situated, at which line, okay, and whether that pattern is provided within that file or not. So for checking all these and the count of that particular pattern, how many times it has been repeated, and whether the same pattern has been available within the other files also within the Unix system. So for knowing about all this, how it is going to search that particular pattern by using this regular expression concept. Okay, so that is what we are going to discuss. So before actually understanding those expression, we need to first understand how the search command is going to work here. This one of the search command which is basically used for searching any of the pattern from a file and knowing whether it has been matching or non-matching for the pattern from that particular file is what? A grep command. So by using this grep command, you can search for any pattern from a file and you can display that. So that is what you are trying to use of a grep command to what? Trying to use a grep command to search for a pattern and display both matching and non-matching in a file. So both matching pattern and non-matching pattern within a file you are trying to display. So by using this grep command, you have a few of the options in which by using those options, so user is able to what? Display at which line the pattern has been associated or situated, okay, whether that pattern has been repeatedly used, and even you can search for what? Apart from that pattern, you can search for other pattern also, and repetitive, whether the same pattern has been available in different files or what. So all these you can do by using what? A grep option. So that is what grep option does. So it is going to get you the line number, count of that file, count of that particular pattern of different similar files or different files. Okay, so that those options have been provided within this grep. Next is what? Regular expression. So you are going to use a complete command line. What you are going to provide itself is a regular expression, okay, along with in that particular command line we are going to use few of the meta characters or wildcards associated within that command line. So those actually you are trying to what? Match those patterns with a multiple patterns by using this regular expression concept, that is meta character concept. By using those meta character concept, you are trying to match a multiple pattern within a same file or within a different file. Okay, next is what you are going to understand again, the next standard what searching of this grep command, that is basic regular expression set, and the next one is significance of characters used within the extended regular expression. So you're going to understand BRE set as well as extended regular expression set. So here how you're going to use different meta characters for searching for a pattern itself. So those sets have been defined within this basic regular expression and extended regular expression. So these are the things what we are going to understand in this particular concept, that is basic and extended regular expression. So before actually entering into what searching for a command, first let us understand what actually this grep command does. So grep command, you have to understand how you are going to search for a pattern within a Unix. So in the Unix, by using this grep command, you are going to search for a pattern. So let me first discuss with this grep command. So grep is basically, as I said, so it is used for searching for a pattern. So let me tell you like in brief. So it is going to scan the input, okay, so input it will be scanned for, input is going to be scanned for what? For a pattern in a file for displaying line number, line where actually that pattern is associated, and the file name also. Okay, even if you want the count, even that will also be displayed. So all these things is going to be done in this what? By using this grep command. So it is going to first scan the input, search for that pattern within a file, what is the file argument you have provided. Then after searching that pattern from that particular file, it is going to display what is the content the user is trying to have it. Whether he just want to display the line where that pattern is associated, or whether he wants to display the line number where that pattern has been associated, or whether he wants to display the count of that particular pattern, and whether the same pattern has been available in different files. So all these it is going to be done by this grep options. Okay, so now let us discuss with the command syntax. So what is the command used for searching for a pattern using this grep command? So using this grep command, so grep is the command. Okay, so grep itself is the command used for searching for a pattern which has been scanned by an input. Okay, so grep followed by option. Option obviously, as I said, so whatever the option line number if you want to display, count of that particular pattern if you want to display, so that is option, and this option is optional always. So either you can give an option or you can not provide that option at all. If you can directly search for a pattern, so at that time it is going to just display that particular line where the pattern has been associated in that file. Okay, next grep option followed by pattern. So this is what actually our main intention, right? Grep command intention. So grep command intention is what you are trying to search for a pattern. So that is what we have considered here. So grep option followed by pattern. Next is what? File name. So this might be with n number, that is more than one file name also can be provided. So only yes, I have given within a bracket, which means that more than one file within the same one of the pattern can be searched within the single file or within the more than one file also. So this is what the syntax command, syntax of using the grep command. So grep option pattern file name. So let me consider one of the file, so that is student.txt file. I'll just what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just display the content what is there in the student.txt file. So this is going to be displayed now. So I'm going to just make you all first understand what is the content is there within the student.txt file. Okay, let me assume first I have what the content displayed is the roll number or the USN, then name, okay, so name of it, then semester, okay, so the semester is 4 as of now. Next ISE, this is a branch followed by, so if you want to display the date of joining, so that can be displayed here. Okay, next followed by the college. So this is how what the content is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just assume here this is what the content is there in the student.txt file. So in the student.txt file I have these content, that is which has been associated within this file student.txt. Now I have to search for a pattern from this file student.txt file. So how do I search that? So you can search that by using what, this grep command. So grep option, as I said, option is optional. So first let us understand how it is going to display a pattern which has been searched from the file, any of the file what we have given as an input. Okay, so this is an input which is there in the student.txt file. So if I give this grep command, so grep followed by pattern. So now I might take any pattern, okay? So whichever the pattern I have, either it might be a number or it might be a character or it might be a date or MITM or it might be a college. Okay, now as of now I am going to give the pattern as what? ISE. Okay, let me consider one of the student with CSE, okay? So ISE, so grep, option I have not given since it is an optional. Pattern I have given, and always pattern should be enclosed within double quotes, followed by the file name you have to provide. So the file name is what? Student.txt file. So this is what I have to search from the file student.txt. That is, ISE pattern has to be searched from the file student.txt. So how do I search? So I have given that as an input to what? Grep command. So shell is going to, what it is going to do is, first it is going to scan for this input, okay? Then it is going to expand or abbreviate what, for what purpose it has been used, the command. So the command here, it is used for what? Searching for a pattern. So the pattern you search, the pattern which it has to search is what? ISE from the file student.txt file. So grep command is going to scan this input pattern ISE from the file student.txt file and display the content here. So here the content from which the two lines which consists of the pattern ISE is what? These are the two lines. One is Ram with the username and the other one is Ramesh with the username. So these are student names. So student name Ram and student name Ramesh having the pattern ISE has been displayed. So what it does is, the shell is going to get you the output after the execution from the kernel. This will be the output you are going to get with grep ISE student.txt. So this is how the output you are going to get. So for searching for a pattern from the file student.txt. Likewise, if you want to search for what? CSE means, so even that is also possible. So you can just give CSE. So at that time, what it is going to display here is, so it is going to display with those two student name, that is, one is with 54 and the other one is 50. So here it is Ravish and here it was Ramya. Okay, so both are from 7th semester from CSE. Okay, so 14, 7, 17, here 16, 8, 17. So both are from MITM College. So this is what the output you are going to get if you give CSE pattern. Likewise, if you just give MITM instead of CSE or ISE, if you just give MITM, so what it does is, it is going to display all the contents or all the lines which is associated with the pattern MITM. So as of now in my file student.txt file, four student details are there. One is Ravish, Ramya and the other one was Ram and Ramesh. So all those four student details will be displayed with this expression. So we call this complete line as what? An expression. Okay, so with this expression it is going to display all the four input from the file student.txt, because MITM has been associated with all those four lines within the student.txt file. So this is how the grep command is used within the Unix. Okay, so here the grep command can also be used for what? This grep command can be provided as an it can get the output from the other file by using a pipe concept. So let me show that example also for you all. Okay, so here, so grep command is also a filter command. So filter, actually what is filter within the Unix system here is, so filter concept is nothing but, since we do have what in the Unix, three standard input files, three standard files, right, redirections files, that is standard input, standard output and standard error. So those commands which take up the input, standard input as well as standard output, we call those commands as what? Filter command. Okay, in that one of the command is what? Grep command, because grep is going to take the output from one which has been displayed to one to that particular grep, and it is going to fetch the same to what? To another file. So grep is also a filter. So okay. So those commands which act as what filters are, one is cat command, WC command, OD command. So all these act as what filter command, because this cat WC OD command is used both. So it is going to take input also from one in from the standard input stream, and WC also can take the input from the standard input stream, and WC can also what provide an output to a standard output stream. Cat also can provide an output to the standard output stream. So both of these commands are used for both the purpose. So only we call those kind of commands which are what a filter command. Here also grep is again one more filter command which is used for both standard input stream and as well as standard output stream. So let me give one example how it is going to act. So who, so what does who do? Who is going to get you the list of user who is going to use on that particular terminal. Account summary or the account details of that particular user will be provided by the who command. So this will be provided as an input to what? Grep. Okay, so this grep, what it does is, so from this who command, if you want to search for any pattern, so you can search for that pattern. Okay, provide that as what output to an another file, that is file.txt. So this is how you are going to use the grep for both getting the input by using a pipe concept and providing the same output which we have got from grep command will be redirected to what file.txt file. So here grep command acts as what filter command. So you can use this grep command in this way also. So in this who, whichever the list has been provided, so that will be provided as an input to the command grep. So in that who output what we have got from who command, in that output if any line or any pattern has been searched with a Kumar, so that line will be considered and the same will be redirected to what file.txt file. So this is how the who command this grep command works. So even grep command is acting as what filter command here. So this is one more way of using the grep command. So next, grep can also return the prompt here. So this grep can also return prompt. What does this mean? So grep can also return the prompt in the case pattern can't be located. So when actually this is going to return a prompt is, assume grep, so in the, if I consider student.txt file, so in that if I consider the pattern Aparna from the file student.txt file, but actually I had the student name with what only four student name, Ram, Ravi, Ramesh, Ravish and what one more Ramya. So only those four student name was there, but Aparna student name was not there associated within that student.txt file. So at that time what does this grep do is, it is going to just return the prompt, because at that time it is not going to locate what, it is unable to locate the pattern what I am trying to search from the file student.txt. So at that time this is going to return the prompt. So this is how the grep command has been used. Now let me list out the grep options which has been used for this command or the grep command. So here one of the option which is used within the grep command here is, that is I, option I. So what is this I option does? So it is going to ignore case, that is hyphen I is going to ignore the case within the pattern. So whatever the pattern, let me assume grep, okay, option I. So I have given in the student.txt as what, Ramya, right? So I might give the pattern as with the small letter R from the student.txt. or I might consider what? Okay, let me take our college name itself, that is MITM. So, but in the file, student.txt file, I had given MITM with all words, all with what? Smaller case, MITM, right? So, here, this MITM, if I have given like this also, it is going to just ignore the case, whatever the case I have given within a pattern, and list out all those lines which are there with the MITM from the file student.txt. So, now it is going to list out all my files which are there from the file student.txt with MITM pattern. So, that is what hyphen I does here. Okay. Likewise, we do have the second option V, that is reverse deleting the line, deleting lines. So, what does this deleting lines refers to? So, I might have given the pattern which is not present within the file at all. Okay, apart from that particular line, if I want to list out the different lines which is associated within that, so at that time I can just use what? Hyphen V. So, grep hyphen V, I'll give ISC student.txt file. So, now what it does? So, this is going to just display, this option hyphen V is going to just display those lines which doesn't contain ISC. Apart from these lines which contain the pattern ISC, remaining lines will be fetched. But the line which consists of ISC will be deleted, but those line which doesn't consists of ISC pattern will be displayed. So, in the student.txt file, one is with Ravish, user student name, and the other with one with what? Ramya. So, these are the two lines which doesn't consists of what? ISC, but it consists of CSC pattern. So, these two lines will get display. So, that is what the use of what? This hyphen V option, that is deleting the line. Okay. So, one is ignore case, hyphen V is for deleting the lines. Next option we do have within this is the third option, hyphen N, that is displaying the line number. So, grep option, one more option within this grep is what? Displaying the line number. So, whatever the pattern I have given, so at which line that pattern is associated, so that line number will be displayed. So, let me consider option hyphen N with CSC, okay, from the file student.txt. So, as we know that the CSC student was displayed at the line number 3rd and 4th, right? So, this is going to display the same output, this. So, line number was 3 and 4. So, these two lines will get display with the option hyphen N. So, this is hyphen N is usually used for what? Displaying the line number. Okay. So, at the line number 3, CSC pattern is there. Line number 4, CSC pattern is there from the file student.txt file. So, next is within this, the next option is what? Next option is hyphen C. So, what does this hyphen C does? So, hyphen C, it is going to get you the line number count. So, counting the line containing the pattern. So, it is going to counting the line containing the pattern. It is going to just count you the line which contains the pattern which you have given. Okay, so let me consider the option grep hyphen C with ISC from the file student.txt. So, it is going to count the line containing the pattern. So, how many lines we do have with an ISC? So, it is ISC pattern is there within the two lines from the file student.txt. So, that will be displayed as an output like this too. Okay. So, these are the few of the options which is there within the grep command. So, we do have few more options which will be continued in the next session. So, along with this, so the which we have discussed in today's session, the options are what? One is hyphen I, ignoring the case, hyphen V, deleting the lines which the user doesn't want, and hyphen N for getting you the number, line number, hyphen C for counting the line number which contains the pattern. How many how many lines has having that particular pattern? So that count is going to be displayed. So this is about your grep option. So remaining options will be discussed in the next session.